Good morning, everyone. Today I am going to discuss a grammar chapter with you. So students, please open your grammar book, page number 102. Welcome to the second session of topic subject verb agreement. The main objectives of this chapter is, today you will be able to learn rules of subject verb agreement. Let's recapitulate what we have learned in our previous video. Number one, the verb must agree with subjects in number, whether in singular or in plural. Look at the example, a dog barks at the stranger. Now next one, singular subjects take singular verb. For example, Ritu has cleaned her room. Plural subjects take plural verbs. For example, we have won the match. Next one, when two or more singular nouns joined by an, it takes a plural verb. Look at the example, Rohan and Meeta have done their work. When the subject consists of two nouns joined with or as well as, the verbs agree with the first subject. Now look at the example, the students as well as the principal were present at the party. A collective noun always takes a singular verb. Look at the example, the packet of erasers is very colorful. Now, let's discuss some other rules of subject verb and agreement. Number one, two or more subjects are connected by or, then it requires singular verb. Look at the example. The book or the pencil box is in the bag. Here we are talking about two subjects. Number one, the book and the pencil box. And it is joined with or. So that's why we have taken singular verb is. Next one, Sanjay, Vijay or Naveen organizes such events regularly. Here we are talking about Sanjay, Vijay and Naveen. They are three singular subjects joined with or. So we have taken singular verb organizes. My aunt or my uncle is arriving by train today. Here we are talking about my aunt or my uncle. Two subjects are there joined by or. So we have taken singular verb is. Next one, my dog or my cat chases squirrels out of the yard. Here we are talking about my dog, one subject, my cat, second subject. It is joined with or. So it will take a singular verb, chases. Next, number two, if two singular subjects are connected by either or neither nor, then it requires singular verb. Look at the examples. Neither the green nor the pink dress is available in our shop. Here we are talking about two subjects, but it is joined with neither and nor. So it has taken a singular verb is. Next one. Neither the employees nor the boss was at work. Here we are talking about two persons, two singular subjects, but it is joined with neither and nor. So it will take a singular verb was. Next one, the indefinite pronouns. Anyone, everyone, someone, no one, nobody are always singular and therefore require singular verbs. Look at the example. Everyone knows the secret. Here we are talking about everyone. Indefinite pronoun. So it will take a singular verb. Knows. Each of the girls has long hairs. Here no doubt we are talking about two girls. But each of the girl has long hair. So each is there. That's why we have taken singular form of the verb has. Next one. Somebody has left her purse. Here we are talking about somebody. It is an indefinite pronoun. So we have taken singular verb has. Next one. If the noun is singular in form but plural in meaning, then it requires plural verb. Now look at the example. Here we are talking about bananas. One dozen bananas cost rupees 100. Here we are talking about one dozen bananas. That means it is singular in form but plural in meaning. That's why we have taken plural verb cost. Next one. If the noun is plural in form but singular in meaning, then it requires singular verb. Look at the example. Here we are talking about mathematics. Mathematics is plural in form but singular in meaning. It is a one subject. So, with mathematics, mathematics is very interesting subject. With mathematics, we will take a singular verb, that is. Next one, physics. Again, plural in form but singular in meaning. So, that's why we have written, physics is my favorite subject. Physics, plural in form but singular in meaning. So, we have taken singular form of the verb is. Next one, no news is a good news. Here we are talking about particular news. So, that's why we have taken singular form of the verb is. Next one, when the plural noun is a proper name, we are talking about plural noun, it is proper name or proper noun, then it must be followed by a singular subject. Look at the example. The United States has a big way. Here we are talking about United States, proper noun. So that's why we have taken singular verb has. Next one. United States of America is a rich country. Here we are talking about United States of America. It is a proper name. So we have taken singular verb is. Next one. Here we are talking about Gulliver's Travels. Gulliver's Travels is read by all the boys and girls. Here we are talking about a particular book. So it is a proper name. That's why we have taken singular verb is. Next rule. If the two singular subjects together express one idea, the verb is in singular form. Look at the example. Here we are talking about bread and butter. So bread and butter is my daily breakfast. Bread and butter express one idea. So that's why we have taken singular verb is. Next one. Slow and steady wins the race. Here we are talking about slow and steady that express one idea. That's why we have taken singular form of the verb wins. Next one. Nouns such as scissors, trousers require plural verbs. Look at the examples. The scissors are sharp. Students, they have given a hint for you. Scissors have two parts. Means two parts, that means it is plural. The scissors are sharp. Scissors plural. So we have taken plural verb are. So the scissors is sharp is incorrect. Next one. The tweezers were lost. Here we are talking about tweezers. Tweezers, that means again two parts. It is plural. So that's why we have taken plural form of the verb were. So the tweezers was lost is incorrect. Next one. We are talking about trousers. Those trousers are very attractive. Here we are talking about trousers. So trousers plural, so we have taken plural verb are.
Let's have a quick review what we have learnt in this video. Number one, two or more subjects are connected by or, then it requires singular verb. For example, Rohan or Mohan has a big hat.
If two singular subjects are connected by either or neither nor, then it requires singular verb. For example, neither Seema nor Reema was present. The indefinite pronouns anyone, everyone, someone, no one, nobody are always singular and therefore require singular verbs. Each of the girls was rewarded. If the noun is singular in form but plural in meaning, then it requires plural verb. For example, 1 kilogram mangoes cost rupees 200. Next one, if the noun is plural in form but singular in meaning, then it requires singular verb. For example, gymnastics is my favorite sport. Next one, when the plural noun is a proper name or proper noun, then it must be followed by a singular verb. For example, politics is an interesting subject.
If the two singular subjects together express one idea, the verb is in the singular. Example, rice and curry is his favorite dish. Nouns such as scissors, trousers require plural verbs. For example, the scissors are red in color.
Today, we have understood the concept of subject, verb and agreement.
Now, you all have to follow your SNAP homework schedule and do the related exercises by your own. Thank you, everyone.